This conference will now be recorded.
Right, let's start. Hope it's audible to everyone. Okay. Right, so in the last class, we have started with modularization techniques and we have discussed how to work with the subroutines. Okay, so one of the modularization technique is what? Subroutines. We understood what is a subroutine, how to define a subroutine and how to call the subroutine, how to pass parameters to subroutines, okay, and how to return the values from the subroutines. And we have seen how to what is the difference between pass by reference and pass by value. Okay, now let us see how to pass internal tables as parameters to what? Subroutines. Passing internal tables as parameters to subroutines. So earlier when you are passing the when you're dealing with the parameters, what are the keywords we have used? We have used using keyword and we have seen what changing keyword. Okay, we have seen that using keyword has to be used when you're dealing with standard data types as what parameters, and changing keyword we have to use for returning the values from the subroutines. Okay, now let us see how to pass internal tables as parameters to subroutines. Okay, so passing internal tables as parameters to subroutines. Type of program is executable program. Done. So we already know how to declare internal tables. So let me declare an internal table. Types begin of, assume that I want to store some employee information. So also types begin of ty underscore emp, employee number type I. Then I'll declare another field, employee name of 20 type C. Then I'll declare another field, employee designation of something 25 type C. Close the types declaration. Then based on this types declaration, let me create the internal table. Type table of ty underscore emp. Okay, so I'll declare a work area also, w underscore emp type ty underscore emp. So since it is a internal table without header, I'm declaring the work area also so that we can use that work area to append the data to the internal table as well as to process our internal table. Okay, so then how do we fill the data into the internal table? First, you need to assign the data to the work area. From work area, we need to append it to internal table. W underscore EMP for employee number. Then also W underscore EMP hyphen employee name. Then W underscore EMP hyphen employee designation. Then I'll say append W underscore EMP to T underscore EMP. So I'm appending the data to the internal table. Let me repeat this process for few more records. So here I'll say employee name, I'll give it as Ashok I'll give it as director. Then I'll give another employee number. This is some data. Okay, so we are having some five records. We are having some five records or some four records, 4, 14, 16, 11, and 8. Five records are there. Okay, so when I do syntax shift, no error. So what I did so far, I created one types declaration. Then I declare an internal table without header. By default, this is standard internal table. Since it is an internal table without header, I declare a work area. Then in order to add the data to the internal table, okay, we need to fill the work area first. From work area, we have to append it to what? Internal table. Now my requirement is, I need to pass this internal table as a parameter to what? Subroutine. I repeat. We need to pass this internal table as a parameter to what? Subroutine. Okay, so first of all, how do we call the subroutine? We use the perform keywords. Perform, let me give a subroutine name. I'll give it as something sub one, perform sub one. Okay, perform sub one. Then I need to pass the internal table as a parameter to what? Subroutine. Right, so in the last class we have seen, for passing standard data types as parameters, we use what keyword? Using keyword. Okay, so now also let me try to use using keyword only. So I'll say using, okay, perform sub one using. Okay, I want to pass internal table as a parameter to what? Subroutine. So what is the name of the internal table here? T underscore EMP. So I'm passing that. Understood? So I'm using the same keyword. Using keyword. Then how do we define the subroutine? By using what? Form and end form. Where do we define the subroutines? At the end of the program. So this is nothing but the end of the program. So it's a form sub one. Okay, form sub one. Here also let me use using keyword. Then I need to give the formal internal table. So already we have seen what are the parameters we pass at the time of calling the subroutines. We call them as what? Actual parameters. And what are the parameters we specify as part of definition? We call them as what? Formal parameters. Okay. Actual parameter name and formal parameter name can be same or it can be different. So let me give it as something using LT underscore what? EMP. Then here also what? End form. End form. Done. Okay. So form sub one. Using LT underscore EMP and end form. Done. So when I do syntax check, as of now, I don't have any errors. I don't have any errors. Now my requirement is, I want to loop this internal table and then display that particular data. Okay, so how do you loop the internal table? We have to use what loop and what end loop statement. So let me say, here I'll say inside the subroutine, I'll say loop at. What is the formal internal table name? LT underscore EMP. Loop at LT underscore EMP. This is an internal table without work area, na, without header. Na. So I need to require, I require an explicit work area. What is the explicit work area declared here? W underscore what? EMP. This is nothing but your work area. Since it is declared outside, it is a global. Means I can use it anywhere in the program. Okay. So here I'll say, loop at LT underscore EMP into W underscore what? EMP. Okay, done. And let me say end loop. I'll say end loop here. So when I do syntax check, good. I got an error. LT underscore EMP is not an internal table. So try to focus on this thing. This is important. Try to understand. Let me comment this once again. So what I'm trying to do here, my internal table is having some 5 records. I want to pass this internal table as a parameter to the subroutine. So I'm calling the subroutine here by using perform keyword. And as usual, I'm using the keyword what using keyword for passing the parameters. But this is not a normal data type. It is not an integer character or it is not a standard data type. It is a internal table. So I'm passing internal with a parameter, but I'm using what keyword? Using keyword. Okay. Then I'm defining the subroutine. At the time of subroutine definition also, I'm using the using keyword. And I specified the formal internal table as LT underscore EMP. This is my actual internal table, T underscore EMP, and this is my formal internal table. So at this stage, when I do syntax check, I don't have any errors. But when I'm trying to use loop and end loop statement, I can use loop and end loop only on what internal table. So when I'm trying to use, it is giving me an error saying that LT underscore EMP is not an internal table. It is not recognizing this LT underscore EMP as an internal table. So it is giving me what syntax error. One second, please. One of the participants is speaking. Okay. One second. Shivan is saying that she has not received. Okay. Done. So when I'm trying to use loop and loop statement, I'm getting what? An error message. Okay, I'm getting an error message. What is the error message? LT underscore EMP is not an internal table. So this is giving me what? Syntax error. So let me comment this. Syntax error. What is the syntax error? LT underscore EMP is not recognized. LT underscore EMP is not recognized. Is not recognized as what? Internal table. Okay, so I'll do a different change. Okay, what I'll do is, let me call another subroutine. So if I leave it like this, it is not giving me any error. Okay, it is not giving me an error. But when I'm trying to use the loop statement on this LT underscore EMP, it is giving the error. So let us see what is the change we have to do. I'll use perform. Let me call another subroutine. Let me give it a sub 2. So what you have to understand is, whenever we are dealing with internal tables as parameters to subroutines, we need to use what tables keyword. We need to use what tables keyword. Okay. Using keyword we have to use whenever you are dealing with what standard data types as what parameters. So now, since I want to pass internal table as parameters, let me use what tables keyword. So tables. What is the name of the internal table? T underscore EMP. Done. Now let me define that subroutine. So where do we define the subroutine? At the end of the program, so form sub 2. Okay, here also we have to use a tables. Let me give a formal internal table as what LT underscore EMP, then end form. Done. Okay, end form. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. No error. I'll try to use a loop statement now. I can use loop only on what internal table. So loop at LT underscore EMP. It is an internal table without header, so I require a separate work area. Already I declared the work area globally. So I'll say into W underscore what? EMP. Then I'll say end loop. Let me try to print it, right? I'll say W underscore EMP hyphen what? Employee number. Then let me say W underscore EMP hyphen employee name. W underscore EMP hyphen, sorry, W underscore EMP hyphen employee designation. Okay, so let me check it. Save. No syntax error. Activate this. I'll execute. I'll say F8. Yes, I got the data. So answer. Okay, so I repeat this once again. Okay, we know this part, how to declare the internal table, how to append the data. So first I created what types declaration. I appended some data to my internal table. Then what was our requirement? This internal table, we have to pass it as a parameter to subroutine. So I called one subroutine, and as usual, I used what keyword? Using keyword for passing the internal table. Then we are receiving it. Okay, inside the sub one, we are receiving it. Then when I'm trying to use loop statement, on this LT underscore EMP, I was getting an error saying that LT underscore EMP not recognized as what? Internal table. So what is the change I have done? I called another subroutine. This time, instead of using keyword, what is the keyword I used? Tables keyword. Then I'm defining at the time of definition also, we have to use a tables keyword. Then I loop the internal table and display it. So the overall understanding is, whenever we are dealing with internal tables as parameters to subroutines, we must use what keyword? Tables keyword. Okay, any questions up to this part, please ask me.
Sir, actually, what I didn't understand, hi, Partho here, parameter as an, I mean, why we need an subroutine here? This part I didn't understand. Because for me, you create an internal area, internal table and work area, and then you append it to the table. So doesn't it is enough for that? I mean, the use of subroutine, I'm hardly understand.
Here I'm not focusing on the use of subroutine. Already we discussed the purpose of subroutine in the last class. What is the purpose of subroutine? It increases what? Reusability. If the same set of statements
right. Inside the program, right?
If the same set of statements has to be executed multiple places in the program, instead of writing that statements again and again, you have to keep that repeated statement inside what? Subroutine. And you can call that subroutine any number of times. That is what is the main usage of what? Subroutine. Okay. So in the last class, we have seen how to pass normal data types as parameters. So for that, I used what? Using keyword. And for returning the data from the subroutine, we are using what? Changing keyword. Now, every time to the subroutine, we may not pass the normal data types as parameters. Sometimes we may require to what? Pass internal table as a parameter to our subroutine. Okay. So we are trying to understand how to pass internal tables as parameters. In this case, yes, without taking the subroutine also, after appending the data, we can loop the internal table directly, I can display. Okay, that is fine. But yet the focus is how to pass the internal table as a parameter. What is the keyword used? Tables keyword. We are trying to understand the usage of tables keyword. Without the subroutine also, I can directly loop and display. But our agenda is just to understand how to deal with what? Internal tables as parameters to subroutines. Okay,
right. Internal tables, I mean this parameters to the internal table, there I think I have some understanding problem. So as you said that you are using a subroutine as a parameter.
No. For the subroutine, I am passing internal table as a parameter. This is
right,
the subroutine
right.
I am trying to call.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, for this subroutine, I am trying to pass internal table as a parameter. So since we are passing internal table as a parameter, we have to use a tables keyword.
Okay, Okay, I will check, and in case I have a problem, I'll get back
I'm
to you on
receiving that in the formal internal table. I'm displaying it. Okay, you'll understand. Let me finish further, then you'll understand it. Yeah. So when I execute, I got the data. Okay, there are the 5 records I got. Now what I'll do? Okay, already we know once a subroutine is executed, the control goes to the next statement from where the subroutine was called. So here only we are calling, the control comes here. Now what I'll do is try to understand. To that internal table T underscore EMP, I'm using what clear statement again. I'll say clear W underscore EMP. Let me add some more data. W underscore EMP hyphen employee number is equal to something. I'll say something 2. Then W underscore EMP hyphen employee name is equal to so and so. Then W underscore EMP hyphen employee designation is equal to, I'll say something director. Then I'll say append W underscore EMP to T underscore EMP. Let me append some more records. Employee number is equal to what? 6. I'll give some employee name. Okay. Done. I'm adding some more data. Right. So I've added 3 more records. Okay. So to the existing internal table, I'm adding what? 2 more, 3 more records. Now again, I want to display the latest data. Okay. So what I have to do, again, I have to loop and display. Now, already, who is taking care of that displaying the data? Subroutine. Now. So what I'll do again? Again, I'll call the same subroutine, perform sub 2 tables. What is the internal table now? T underscore EMP. Okay, so control goes to what? Subroutine definition. Okay, control goes to subroutine definition, it will display that. Understood? Let me execute this. Okay, see, okay. See the, here I'll just put the underline kind of thing. So see this, when I say F8, yes, earlier we have only 5 records. Then I am having how many records? Some 8 records. Let me debug, then it will be more clear. See this. I'll put the breakpoint. Just try to understand.
So sir, in short, yeah. It will copy the data from the work area to the body of the table, right?
Which one?
I'm saying you created in the work area. So you're passing the data from that work area to body of the things, and that is what we are using the subroutine?
No. Subroutine nowhere related to that. Okay. Let me debug this, then you'll understand it. See here. I'm saying F8. I'll switch to the old debugger. So just try to focus here. Forget about subroutine. Already we know internal tables, we have seen many examples. What is an internal table? Internal table is the one which can store multiple records. How do you fill the data to the internal table? Already we know. First, we need to assign the data to the work area. From work area, we need to add it to the internal table. That is done either by using append statement or what? Insert statement. Okay. So focus is on internal tables. No. Forget about subroutine. Okay. So at this stage, if you see T underscore EMP, my internal rule is what? Empty. It is initial. Doesn't have any data. Okay, see here, internal table is blank, doesn't have any data. Okay, so what I am doing here, how do we assign the data to the internal table? Already we have seen this. Again, we should not focus on this part. So when I say F5, I am assigning the data to the work area. One second, let me switch to the class debugger. Yeah, I'll say F5, done. So I'm assigning the data to the work area. From work area, we are appending it to the internal table. So what this append statement will do, it will append the data from work area to the end of the internal table. So when I say F5, yes, I got one record in the internal table. See the content here. If you see this, yes, I got one record. Again, let me go to the fields button. Yeah, now I'll say F5. Then I'm cleaning the work area, assigning the new data to the work area. Again, we are using append. Yes, one more record got appended. How many records are there? Two records. Okay, so let me debug this. Three records, four records, five records. So what we have done so far is we have appended the data to the internal table. So at this stage, my internal table is having some five records. So what is my agenda now? I want to display this data from the internal table. So how do we display the data from the internal table? We have to use what loop and what end loop statement. So that loop statement will copy the data from body to what work area. Once it is copied to the work area, control enters the loop statement. By using the write statement, we can display the data from the work area. I can do like that. But that display logic, instead of writing it individually, I want to write that inside a subroutine. So that the advantage of writing that in the subroutine is what I can call that subroutine any number of times. I can direct without using subroutine, I can just loop and display that anyhow we know. Already we have seen that last week. Now my requirement is I want to put that display logic inside a subroutine so that I can call that subroutine, same subroutine n number of what times. So first time what I am doing here, I am calling the subroutine by using perform statement. What is the subroutine I am trying to call? Sub one. And I am passing the internal table as a parameter. What is the keyword I am using for passing the internal table? Using keyword. I can use using keyword only when you are passing standard data types as parameters, like when you are passing integer, character, date, time, those kind of variables. If you are passing as parameters, we have to use using keyword. Okay, now I'm using what t underscore emp, which is an internal table, which is an internal table. Okay, I'm using what using keyword. Let's see what happens. I'll say fi. Yes, control will go to the subroutine. So in the subroutine, what I tried to use, I tried to use loop statement, but it was giving syntax error. I can use loop only if it is an internal table. But since I am receiving this internal table using what keyword? Using keyword. It is not recognized as what? Internal table. It is not recognized as internal table. So it was giving the syntax error. So nothing I am doing in the subroutine. So control is coming out of this first subroutine. Nothing you have done in the first subroutine. I'll say fi done. Underline. Then I am calling another subroutine. I'm calling another subroutine, sub two. I'm calling this time. What is the keyword I'm using? And keyword tables. Whenever you are passing tables as parameters to a subroutine, tables keyword. Okay. So in this t underscore emp, how many records are there? Five records. So when I say fi, control jumps to subroutine definition. So let me say fi. Yes, control is jumping to the subroutine definition. Those five records from that t underscore emp will be copied to what? Lt underscore emp. So if you see lt underscore emp, observe here. Lt underscore emp, it is also an internal table. You can see the symbol here. Okay. I can check the data here. See, I'll go to table. What is the internal table? Lt underscore emp. When I press enter, yes, what happened here? The internal table for the data is copied from t underscore emp to lt underscore emp. We have those five records. We are in those five records. Done. So I'm looping that internal table. I'm displaying. How many times it will loop? Five times. Because my lt underscore emp contains how many records? Five records. So let me loop it here. I'll say fi. Done. So I'm looping. First record will be displayed. See this. See the output list. I got the first record like this. When I say fi, it will loop for five times. Okay, so let it loop for five times. Done. Yes, I got all the five records. If you see the output here, yes, I got all the five records. Five records are displayed. Done. Since there are no further records to loop further, the control comes out of the loop statement. So when I say fi, there are no records, so control is coming out of the subroutine. Okay, fi done. Okay, so already what you have done so far, I displayed the data from the internal table. Where you have written this logic inside the subroutine. Okay, done. Next, again the control is coming out of the subroutine. We are adding some data to my original internal table. What is my original internal table? T underscore EMP, which has already got how many records? Five records, which has already got five records. So when I say FI, okay, I'm appending now. Now I got six records. I got six records. Then FI, seventh record is appended. Then eighth record is appended. Done. So initially my internal table was having five records. I pass that internal table as a parameter to subroutine. Inside my subroutine definition, I received that T underscore EMP data into LT underscore EMP. I am looping that and I display that. Now, again, what you are doing to my original internal table, I have appended some three more records. Now I want to reprint the data in that internal table. So I have to loop it and display now. Already I wrote that display logic inside what? Subroutine. So I can call the same subroutine once again. So again, I'm calling the same subroutine sub 2 once again. I have defined it only once, but I'm calling it more than once. So this time T underscore EMP is having how many records? Eight records. So when I say FI, control has gone to the subroutine definition. Those eight records will be copied to my formal internal table. If you see, this is LT underscore EMP. See, this time it has got how many records? Eight records. So now what you are doing here, we are looping it. So how many times it will be iterated? Eight times. Okay. I am not interested to debug all these things. So how to come out of the debugging? Press what? F8. Okay. So what I am trying to show here is, initially my internal was having five records. I passed that to the subroutine. It has looped it and displayed. Then to the same original internal table, I have appended three more records. Again, I want to redisplay. So instead of writing that logic once again, simply I call the same subroutine once again. Reusability. We have defined it only once. Form into form, I have defined it only once. But I'm calling it what? Twice. Same subroutine, sub 2. I'm calling it multiple places in my program. Reusability.
Yes, sir. I got it now.
Right?
Thank you.
Yeah, others, any questions? Okay, so what you have to understand so far is, whenever we are passing internal tables as parameters to a subroutine, what is the keyword you have to use? Tables keyword. Done. So I passed it. Now what I'll do is, my next requirement is, just try to understand. My next requirement is, my internal table, this is my latest internal table. My internal table contains how many records? It contains some 8 records. Okay, this is my internal, which has what? 8 records. Now my requirement is, I want to pass this internal table data to a subroutine, and what that subroutine has to do is, it has to delete all managers. Okay, so let me check it now. So what I'll do now at this stage here, I'll say, okay, this is my subroutine definition. One second, please. Okay, done. So my requirement is, I want to delete all the managers from my internal table. Okay, and I want to do that task inside a subroutine. So what is the subroutine is doing? It is just looping that internal table and displaying the data as it is. It is not doing any modifications. Now I'll say, see here, subroutines has to be defined at the end of the program. So what I'll do, somewhere here I'll say, uline, I'll say perform I'll give a subroutine name as what? Sub 3. Okay, I'll give a subroutine name as sub 3. I'll say tables t underscore what? EMP. Perform sub 3 tables t underscore EMP. Okay, done. So just focus at this stage. This internal double has got how many records? 8 records. It has got 8 records. Okay, done. Now I have to define that subroutine. If I leave it like this, obviously I'll get an error saying that sub 3 is not defined. So when I do syntax check, yes, I got an error. The form sub 3 does not exist. You are calling the subroutine, but you have not defined the subroutine. So let me define it here. So somewhere here I'll say form sub 3. Again, I have to use what keyword? Tables keyword. Let me give the formal internal table as LT underscore EMP and what? End form. Done. End form. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. So what is my agenda now? I want to delete the records. I want to delete the records from the internal table. Wherever the designation is what? Manager. Wherever the designation is manager. So I'll say, try to understand. Delete. What is the internal table? LT underscore EMP, delete LT underscore EMP, where EMP desig, I have to do the deletion based on employee designation column only, na, where EMP designation is equal to what? Manager. Okay, so I'm trying to introduce to you a new statement. What is that? Delete statement. Okay, so delete is for deleting the data from the internal table. So let me check whether I'll get the result or not when I do syntax check. Yes, I got a syntax error. What is the syntax error? The row type of the table must be identifiable statically in where class. The row type of the table must be identifiable statically in what? Where class. So what you have to understand is, just focus on the sub to internal table. What you are doing the sub to internal table? We are just passing the internal table. We have received that internal table in LT underscore EMP. We are just looping and displaying. I'm just looping and displaying. I'm not modifying the data. I am not deleting any data. I'm receiving it. I'm displaying it as it is. But whenever you are doing any changes, whenever you are modifying the data or whenever you are deleting the data, okay, it is giving me an error. What is the error I got? The row type of the table must be identified statically in what? Where class. So whenever we are deleting or modifying the data, we must specify the row type of the internal table. Row type of the internal table means we have to specify the structure of the internal table. We have to specify the structure in the sense what are the fields in that particular header. So what you have to do here, see this, observe this. Here you have to say, as part of definition, you have to use the keyword structure. What is the work area I declared for my internal table? What is the work area? W underscore EMP. Na? So you have to say structure W underscore EMP. Let me check it now. Save it. Check it. No syntax error. I repeat once again. Why I am not using the structure keyword in case of sub 2 is, in sub 2 what I am doing? I am just looping and displaying. But whenever we are altering the data in the internal table, in the subroutine, that is, whenever you are modifying or deleting, you must specify the structure of the internal table. How do you specify? Here we have to use the keyword what? Structure. What is the error I got? You have to go by error. What is the error I got? The row type. Row type is nothing but what? Work area. Okay, so here you have to say, row type is nothing but structure, line type, nothing but structure, work area. So here you have to use the keyword structure. What is the work area declared for that? W underscore what? EM. Done. Let me check it now. Save it. Check. No syntax here. Done. So you are deleting the data from which internal table? LT underscore EMP. So focus this once again. So if you focus here, at this EMP has got how many records? 8 records. Those 8 records I am passing into the subroutine. I am receiving an LT underscore EMP. So LT underscore EMP also contains 8 records. What I am doing inside the internal table, I am trying to delete the data from LT underscore EMP. What data I'm trying to delete? Wherever the designation is what? Manager. So I'm deleting the data from, formal internal table. Let me check whether it will reflect actual internal table. What is the actual internal table? T underscore EMP. How can you check it here? Again, you have to display it, loop it and display it. Already that loop and loop, that looping is done by which subroutine? Sub2. Let me call it again. Perform sub2. Okay, tables. What is the internal table? T underscore EMP. For your understanding, I'll just give a message. Data in T underscore EMP. After deleting what? After deleting managers. This is only for understanding. After deleting managers from what? LT underscore EMP. I'm deleting from LT underscore EMP. I want to check whether it's reflecting what T underscore EMP or not. So let me check it when I execute this. Yes. What happened here? You can see data in T underscore EMP. After deleting managers from LT underscore MP, what are the records arriving again? Only 5 records. Means I don't have what? Managers now. So what is happening? Whatever the deletion you have done on formal internal table, it got reflected to what? Actual internal table also. What is the actual internal table? T underscore what? EMP. Okay, I'll debug, just try to focus. Yeah, I'll put the breakpoint here. Well, before calling the subroutine, I'm putting the breakpoint. Just try to focus. Let me say F8. Let me switch to old debugger. Done. So if you see T underscore EMP, how many records it is clearly showing here? 8 records are there. At the time of calling the subroutine sub 3, it is having what? 8 records. Yes, we are having 8 records. Done. Now I'm saying F5. Control jumps to subroutine definition. Yes, control has gone to subroutine definition. Okay, these 8 records from this actual internal table will be copied to what? Formal internal table. What is the formal internal table here? LT underscore EMP. Let me check whether they are copied or not. So if you see LT underscore EMP, okay, I want to check the data in this, whether 8 records are there or not. So let me go to what? Table. Let me give LT underscore EMP here. Yes, you can see 4 records. Scroll down. Yes, we are having what? 8 records, which includes what? Managers. There are some 2 records with managers. So my formal internal table also at this stage contains how many records? 8 records. What I am doing now? I am deleting from LT underscore EMP. So at this say LT underscore EMP has got 8 records. So when I say F5, observe the change. My actual internal table contains what? 8 records. But I am not deleting the data from actual internal table. I am trying to use the delete statement on what? Formal internal table. So when I say F5, yes, see here. If you see LT underscore EMP, see LT underscore EMP earlier has got 8 records. Now it has got only what? 5 records. So the moment I deleted from formal internal table, it also deleted from what? Actual internal table. Actual internal also contains how many records now? 5 records. So what is the understanding? The changes you have done to the data formal internal table will automatically reflect what? Actual internal table. Nothing but what? Passed by reference. Last class you have seen passed by reference. Any changes made to the data of formal internal table will actually reflect what? Data of what? Actual internal table. That's what is happening here. So when I say F5, yeah, this time again I'm calling now. I'm calling sub 2. How many T underscore EMP has got? How many records at this stage? 5 records. So this 5 records will be passed to that subroutine and they are received in LT underscore EMP. It will iterate for 5 times, it will display. Let me say F8 will come out of the sub, it will come out of the program debugging. Right? I got the 5 records. So the point you have to focus here is in sub 2 and sub 3, I am passing internal as parameter. But when I am doing sub, when I am defining sub 2, I didn't mention any structure keyword here because inside my sub 2, what I'm doing on the internal table, I'm just looping and displaying. I'm not inserting, I'm not modifying, I'm not deleting anything. Just I'm reading and displaying. So at that time, I should not specify any structure. But in sub 3, what you're doing, you're trying to perform some delete operation. or whenever you try to modify something, you have to specify the structure of the internal table. Nothing but you have to specify the row type of the internal table. How do you specify? We have to use the structure keyword. So this is what we understood, and we also understood that the changes made to the data of formal internal table will automatically reflect the data of what? Actual internal table, which means what? The internal table is by default passed by what? Reference. Is passed by reference. Any questions, please ask me.
Yes, sir. Can we mention TY underscore EMP instead of work area, sir? Then?
Okay, let us try it here only. See, I'm using TY underscore EMP. When I do syntax check, it is unknown, not recognizing. So you have to go for work area.
Okay, sir.
Amshi, you are asking this only, na?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That one.
Okay. Row type, what was the error we got? Row type now. Row type is nothing but what? Work area. This is only a types declaration. Types declaration doesn't allocate any memory now. So you must specify, you must refer to what? Work area only. Nothing but row type, or we call it as line type. Any other doubts, others? Yeah, Manika, here our discussion is how to pass internal to the parameter. The question you asked is a different one, right? There is something called as collect statement. For the time being, my answer is collect statement. By using collect statement, I can do the sum of salaries of all the employees. Any questions relevant to this part?
Yeah, sir, with these changes, delete IT underscore IT. EMP. And here the form subroutine tree tables IT EMP structure, when you make these changes, original structure, that original structure
original
not
internal original internal table.
So this internal table is calling a structure, and there you are modifying that.
No, the wordings should be here. We are not calling any structure here. We are only
specifying
the structure of the internal table. When I don't specify, I got an error. I got an error. What is the error? The row type of the table must be identified statically. Means we need to specify the structure of the internal table. Structure of the internal table means I know that my internal table contains how many fields? Three fields: employee number, employee name, employee designation. So that we have to inform to SAP. How do we inform to SAP? By using the keyword what? Structure. That only this indicates, sir.
Okay,
we are specifying the structure of the internal table.
Okay. So it has nothing to do with the callings. Okay, fine, sir.
No, just to avoid this error. Okay, so why we got the error? Because we are using delete or modify or insert statement on the internal table. At that time, it is mandated to specify the structure of the internal table. If you only loop and display, I need not specify the structure of the internal table. But if you use other than loop, if I use delete or modify or any other insert statements, at that time we must statically specify the structure by using what? Structure keyword.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay, now when I execute this, okay, this is the data I'm having. This is a data analysis. Now my requirement is okay, at this stage T underscore EMP has got all records, some five records. My requirement now is wherever employee is there, that should be updated to senior employee. How many records are there with employee? Three records are there. So that should be updated to modified to what? Senior employee. So I want to do that task inside a subroutine. So what I'll do again here, somewhere here. One second, please. Yeah, U line. I'll call a different subroutine, perform sub 4. Perform sub 4. Perform sub 4. I'll use a keyword what? Table. Perform sub 4 tables. What internal table? T underscore what? ENT. Perform sub 4 tables T underscore ENT. Let me define that. So somewhere here I'll say form sub 4. Okay, here you have to use what keyword? Tables keyword. Let me give a formal internal table name as what? LT underscore EMP and also what? End form. Done. End form. Now here I'll say, okay, what is my requirement? I want to modify employees to what? Senior employees. So since I have to alter, I have to use what statement? Modify statement. Modify what? LT underscore EMP, modify LT underscore EMP, or let me do it in different way. I'll say clear W underscore EMP, W underscore EMP. I'll say W underscore EMP hyphen employee designation equal to, what is the modified designation you want? Senior employee. So I'll say senior employee, done. Then you update the internal table, modify LT underscore EMP from W underscore EMP, okay, modify LT underscore EMP from W underscore EMP, where EMP designation is equal to employee. Wherever the designation is employee, modify those records from that W underscore EMP, transporting EMP design. So transporting addition already we have seen in the read statement. Now I'm using it for what? Modify statement. Let me just check it first, then I'll explain. I got an error. Unable to interpret where class. So let me use modify table. Oh, again, I got error. Modify LT underscore EMP from so and so. Let me use transporting EMP design. Where employee designation equal to what? Employee. Let me check the syntax, save it, check it. The specified does not have a component called as EMP design. Once again, modify table. Let me save it. Check for this. The specified type does not have a structure. Oh, I have not specified the structure here. No? So I got the error here. So since I'm using modify, I need to specify the structure. Also, what structure? What is the structure? W underscore what? EMP. Save it. Check for the syntax. I don't have any errors at this stage. Let me again redisplay it. So again, I'll say. So what is the subroutine which is displaying the data? Sub 2. So data in T underscore EMP after what? After modifying what? Employees to what? Senior employees. So let me just check it whether I'm getting or I'll getting any runtime error. Let me save it, check for the syntax, no error. Let me execute this. Okay, scroll down and check. Good, it is changing to what? Senior employee. So focus here, just observe this. I'm putting the breakpoint here, right? So what I'm doing here, I'm calling the subroutine sub 4, I'm passing this T underscore EMP, try to focus. Let me switch to classic debugger. I'm switching to classic debugger, right? I'm calling the subroutine. At this stage, T underscore EMP has got how many records? 5 records. Yes, I'm calling the subroutine. Control goes to the subroutine definition. These 5 records are received in what? LT underscore EMP. So if you see here, LT underscore EMP also will have those 5 records. Yes, I'm having those 5 records. You can see it. There are the 5 records. And normally records are having employee, this is having employee, this is having employee, this is having the employee. Second record, third record, and fifth record is having what? Employee. So what is my agenda here? I have to update my internal table. I have to modify my internal table. So how do you modify? First you have to set the modified value to the work area. Then referring to work area, you have to update the internal table. So remember, directly I cannot update the internal table. First you have to set the modified value to the work area. Then referring to the work area, you have to update what? Internal table. So what I'm doing here, this is my work area, W underscore EMP. So in W underscore EMP, if an employee designation, if you see, I'm setting the modified value. What is the modified value I'm setting? See, senior employee. So I'm assigning the modified value to the work area. But if you see the LT underscore EMP, still it is having what? Employee only. Okay. So this is a formal internal table. Done. So what I'm doing here, modify my formal internal table from what? W underscore EMP transporting. What is the field I have to compare? Employee designation. So what it will do here, and where you have to do that modification? Wherever the designation is what? Employee. So it will take the first record internally. It will take the first record. What is the designation here? Director, not satisfied. It will take the second record. What is the designation here? Employee. Yes, this. Where condition is satisfied. So what you are doing, you know, modify LT underscore EMP from W underscore EMP. Okay, transporting employee designation means we are telling to compare only this employee designation between this internal table and what? Work area. So if you see this work area designation, what is the modified value? Senior employee. So I'm saying modify LT underscore EMP from W underscore EMP transporting what? EMP. Design. So my LT underscore EMP has got three fields here. Employee number, this one. Employee number, employee name, and employee designation. We are telling SAP to compare only what? Employee designation. So this employee will be updated to what? Senior employee, because we are updating the internal table from what? W underscore EMP. Already W underscore EMP contains modified values. So when I say FI, observe this. This will be changed to what? Senior employee, when I say F5. Done. You can see it has got updated to what? This record got updated to senior employee, this record to senior employee, again, this record to what? Senior employee. So we are modifying which internal table? Formal internal table. But just now we have seen any changes made to what? Formal internal table will automatically reflect what? Actual internal table. So what is the actual internal table here? T underscore EMP. So that also will be reflected. See now, if you see T underscore EMP, yes, in T underscore EMP also it got reflected. That's all. So the point you have to understand from this point, this subroutine 4 is how to update the internal table. How to update? By using what? Modify statement. I cannot directly modify the internal table. First, we need to set the modified value to the work area. And then referring to the work area, you must use what? Update the internal table by using modify statement. Which records you have to modify? Wherever designation is equal to what? Employee. So there are overall 5 records. Out of 5 records, only 3 records satisfy this where condition. And in that 3 records, what changes it will do? Wherever what employee is there, that will be updated to senior employee, because we are saying from W underscore EMP. So what is the logic behind modifying the internal table? First, assign the modified value to what? Work area. Then, referring to work area, use the modifier statement along with the where class. And any modifications you have done it to formal internal table will automatically reflect actual internal table. That's what we are doing. We are again calling the subroutine sub to again. I am passing my original internal table. I got the data from the original internal table only. We got some fire records with the modified data. This one. Any questions, please ask. Since I am using modifier, again you have to specify the structure of the internal table. For this, I have not specified any structure because we are only receiving that and just looping and displaying. We are not deleting or we are not doing any modification. Whenever we use delete and modify on the internal table, I must specify the structure of the internal table, and that is done by using what structure keyword. Any questions, please ask. Then, so practice this part. Tomorrow we'll see how to work with external subroutines. Today and day after, day before yesterday, we have seen how to deal with internal subroutines. Internal subroutines which are defined as well as called from the what? Same subroutine, which are defined and called from the same subroutine. Okay, external means which is defined in some other program and called from some other program. So that part we'll start discussing from tomorrow, but this is important. This modulation techniques, internal techniques is very important before we get into database programming or any other thing. This is base for the rest of the course. While listening, it looks simple, okay, but refer to the notes and the what recordings, all those things, so that you'll get the subject. Okay, any other questions, please ask me, otherwise I'll wind up for today. Done, Chaladan. So if you don't have questions, I'll try to share the recording in next 1 or 2 hours practice so that you'll feel comfortable from tomorrow onwards. Chaladan.